What's up, everybody? It is Hobbs here for a very late Wild Eye Wednesday. And today we are going to discuss the last 5 days. That is what we are going to review today. I want to thank Wild Eye Releasing for sending me this one to review. I'll put the link into the description at the bottom. And let's get directly into this found footage film. It is approximately 71 minutes. Is a 2020 release. I believe it was probably done a little earlier, but the release came out in 2020, so we're gonna roll with that. Show you the insides here. No, I don't believe this has the blue treatment, but I know it doesn't. So, correct me if I am incorrect, please. This stars Adam Barati, Dan Weisgerber, Jason McCready, Dustin Pennington, and Sandra Williams. Starring Joe Pacini and Clay Moffat as well. So, let me give you a fair assessment of this one here, because I just want to be as honest as I can on this. I love found footage. But found footage for me has to be really good found footage. Like, it has to be spot on. The Blair Witch, to me, is the coup de grace. Although I've not seen Poughkeepsie tapes, I'm dying to see that one. I hear that that one actually might be slightly better than the Blair Witch. I definitely want to see that one, you know, as well. But, you know, when it comes to found footage, I need it to be good. Yeah, it's just where I am. It's not a knock on anything, but I really like my found footage films to be spot on. I think it's one that you have a really degree of difficulty to kind of get through. So what we have here is we have these students that want to make a film, essentially. And it's a, you know, it's two guys, and they do, you know, live together. And you would want to think that they live together in a dorm, because in college, that's where they're at. Generally, two kids alone don't live in a house that looks like it's about $500,000. But they do. So, if these two kids, they keep hearing about this place that's had all these brutal killings and stuff, and has a lot of history of potential haunts, potential aliens, potential killings. So they want to go film it for their film class, and they want to make a movie, like a documentary, out of it. So, essentially, that's the premise of the film and the objective. So, they go out to this place. They go out there to essentially start the investigating, and things start to happen to them, as you would see in a found footage film. Oddly enough, they find a piece of fruit. And their idea is to take the fruit home and eat it. I'm not sure exactly why, as they're being possessed by some type of a demon or something that is causing them to go nuts when they eat this particular piece of fruit or this particular piece of food. They start to go a little bit crazy. And, you know, I don't want to give away too much, but shit starts to go crazy inside the house between the boys and... They're filming the event of them going crazy, like possibly being possessed. The other guy's like, my roommate's going nuts. I don't know what to do here. Help me out. And, you know, I got to be honest with you guys on this one. I liked the parts where they were out in the woods trying to do the documentary. But when they got back to the house, it just fell extremely flat for me. Extremely flat. And... I felt like the cameras that were being used for this film were very, very bad. I mean, I feel like it was filmed on an iPhone. And again, I don't know the budget for this, but that's how bad it looked. I mean, I feel like if you're going to go full investment on a film like this, even if you have a $1,000 budget, you should be able to find another way to film with better camera angles. Again, I'm not knocking anybody, but I just didn't feel like the camera, the lighting and everything was the way it should have been in this, in my opinion. Again, just my opinion. I didn't like the gore at all. I thought the gore The special effects were very off on this one. I felt like it was just two guys that had a camera and they wanted to just film just the two of them being silly, trying to pretend like they're making a movie. That's the feeling I got of that. And I mean, no disrespect. That's just my opinions. I'm not going to give away the ending, but this one had a lot of potential for Wild Eye, and I wish it just would have been a little better. Actually, a lot better. I cannot recommend this one right now to anybody. Don't take that personal. I just can't. If you see it, you may have a different thought on it, though. If you did see it and you liked it, tell me why you liked it. Maybe I'll have to watch it again. Maybe I missed something. Anyways, that is my review for the last 5 days. Hope you guys are having a wonderful rest of your week. Shout out to everybody in the community today. All the birthdays and everything that's going on this week. Martin, I'm glad you liked your package, man. You know, that made me happy to see that you got it. And I'll catch up with you guys later. This is Hobbs. Peace.